The road coming in and out of this deal is about, I would say, a 2,500 foot change from top to bottom. And you go down about 30-40% grades on this road coming in and out of this river. And
once all loose rock.
You start the morning off just getting beat to hell, and then you end the evening just getting beat to hell driving back up that road.
I couldn't be happier. It just doesn't get any better. An adventure. This is more than a hunt.
Move it down here and catch a big old catfish while you're at it.
Yeah. I've been thinking about that catfish for 11 months. Him and his catfish. These boys from West Texas.
Bruce told me that he wants a good, mature animal of the species. That's his main concern, is good, heavy, broomed off ram. In the morning, we're going to get up and we're going to get on two canoes. We've got a crew here of six. We'll get on the Rio Grande in the morning and float downstream, do a lot of glassing, and try to stay cool in the summer heat. But we should have some good luck. We saw a lot of sheep down here close to the water this evening. So we've seen about, I think I've counted 24 since we've started this evening. So good start to a nice first day.
Where are we at, Bruce?
We're at the Rio Grande River, brother.
What are we doing?
We're sheep hunting, bro. Desert bighorn on the Rio Grande.
Okay, we're gonna go down around the point here. We're gonna glass the bowl where we saw those sheep yesterday evening and see if there's a big ram that's moved into those ewes.
Sound like a deal, bro. Let's go find it.
We'll get on. Oh, yep.
How far above them?
Right over the top of them now. Right
into them. It's
a very, very young ram.
Small.
I just seen it.
That's okay.
He's around.
We need to find him. Mm-hmm. Then we can come back and hunt him.
Mm-hmm. But I want to kill some time here though, because we're a little bit ahead.
Cool. You want to fish?
We can fish.
We're fixing to go swimming.
You don't even know, but that's all right.
We've seen a lot of wild, wild maverick cattle on the river.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
When we get the sheep hunt concluded, we might get us a trophy bull.
We might dust one of them. Yeah. And we saw some really cool alligator tracks.
Yes, we did.
Yes, we did.
Caught a catfish.
Caught a catfish. It's been a cool day.
It's been a long day. We rode upstream about 3 miles. We've seen probably 20 sheep. Saw another nice ram today. Just a little bit too young. What is it, day three? Three and a half?
Three and a half.
Three and a half. Three full days of rowing this boat. We've got a lot of weight in here. We did kill a bull today. Killed a wild bull.
How far is it? Yeah. Thank you.
We're gonna go get him tomorrow.
Day four of Bruce's hunt, and we're at a place called A Little Piece of Heaven. It's what the locals call it, and I can see why. It's absolutely gorgeous. You got the Rio Grande, you got Mexico, you got Texas, and it's absolutely beautiful. The neighboring property over here is where they relocated a bunch of desert sheep. I sure would like to be the one that finds the sheep, so I'm gonna shut my mouth and get back to glassing.
Maybe be eight guys looking for one sheep. We could be here a while. That's okay.
Eight guys looking for one sheep. We got them outnumbered. Do you think we'd get it done?
Yeah, we're gonna get something done. No doubt about that. We'll get something done. This would be day five of fun in the sun on the Rio Grande.
We're fixing to paddle upstream about 3 or 4 miles again. We got a spotter up on top of a vantage point, and he's got some sheep found and trying to get satellite signal. Get a hold of him again, but we'll see what he says.
We're looking for a sheep we nicknamed Turnout. Maybe we'll get lucky today.
Walking around a little faster part. We've rode upstream now about 5.5 miles. Another mile and a half. We're gonna have somebody come pick us up. Tomorrow we'll go downstream. Bruce Harvey sheep hunt. Look at the country. Unbelievable.
Today's day five. It has been physically challenging. I would say that's a fair statement.
Yeah.
And yeah, we did about 10 miles upstream today in these boats. That was interesting, and got it done. Saw some sheep. It's either one nice ram. Just wasn't quite old enough.
Right. This is the most physically demanding hunt you can do, in my opinion. Being the summer heat, being July in this terrain, but it's been an eventful hunt. I know I'm worn out. I can't imagine what Bruce feels like after 5 days of paddling and going up and down the river.
It's a test, but get in shape for it. You want to come play this game, you really need to think about it a year ahead of time. You better start exercising at least 6 months ahead of time, and I mean exercising, because this is going to pull it out of you.
You're crushing rock and river, but 20 feet wide water gushing in your face, paddling upstream or pulling the boat upstream is just as extreme as walking up these mountains every day.
Pulls a lot of horsepower out of you. We hunted 6 days, and we're breaking camp this morning. I'm going to take a break and come back on the 25th. Season's over on the 31st, and see if we can't find a mature ram.
Well, made it to Phoenix, Arizona. Heading to Midland, Odessa. Meet up with Bruce Harvey to head out on the second leg of his sheep hunt. Fortunately, on the first trip, we weren't successful harvesting a sheep. So lucky for us, we get to come back. So.
We put this in the pack at 7 this morning, something like that. 3:30, West Texas, over 100 degree heat on the Rio Grande. Check it out, not bad. Kitty light.
You made me thirsty.
Yeti cooler, wildly stronger, keep ice longer.
We had a surprise this morning. The river rose 2 to 3 feet today. Our plan was to row upstream about 4 miles to the bull, maybe a little bit further to the bull, and it's kicking our ass today, to be honest with you. Everybody's tired, and we've only went maybe a mile, so we're taking a break here on the side of the bank, catching our breath, and we're gonna try to tackle some more of it. It'll be easy going back downstream. Much easier than we've had in the past, but going upstream's the hardest we've had so far. I don't know if you can see that water moving or not back here behind Bruce, but it's moving. So, the old Rio Grande's kicking our ass today. We're up for it though.
I would be okay with that sheep, and I would be. I would be okay with that sheep. I prefer to go to the bowl and see if something else hasn't moved in and hunt our way easy down
the Something big is gonna be with those ewes at some point. We all know that. And all the ewes are in the bowl.
So we're gonna go up here to the bowl again and look again. And if our rams aren't there, we're gonna go back downriver and shoot the ram that likely saved for this afternoon. If we get to the bowl, which I think we will.
Turnout ram that Bruce has been hunting here. We put 17 days in this sheet. We saw him on day 2. And a year later we found him again.
Well, yeah.
He's got about 12 ewes and one young ram. And it's definitely him. He's a big dog.
There, you're clear now.
Yeah. You got him. Dead. Standing there dead.
Huh? He's hit him. Hit him again.
Yep.
He's going down.
Over, buddy.
Hold on. Hold on.
You hit high.
You hit high.
Bruce, calm down. Hold on.
He's
Bruce
dying right there, good. Bruce. He's dying
he's
right
good.
There.
He's dead. Just stay on.
He just died. He's dead. Funny.
He didn't even flinch.
You got him in the heart. First
yeah,
shot.
Yeah, first shot should have been, yeah.
God, that's the hardest earned son of a bitch I've ever seen right there.
Oh, yeah, that's the biggest sheep ever killed on this ground.
You don't look at me, that guy. You don't look at me, that guy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
And kill the one we wanted.
We earned that motherfucker.
And he is a stud. Oh.
I couldn't have posed these any better. Huh?
Any better.
Why?
I got him at 11.
Thank you, Lord.
10 or 11. I get him out of that bush.
Either way.
He's damn sure not under 8.
That's awesome. Well, we sit here today. We've had our little toast. And it's just been... an adventure. This is more than a hunt, way more than a hunt. To find something last year, see it, dream about it, think about it, physically get in shape for it, work your ass off, and then just have it all come together is, well, I'm gonna leave out a lot of 11 days of hunting and the bullshit, and it's not an easy hunt out here. It's just not an easy hunt. End up with exactly the sheep we were looking for, a needle in a haystack. It's just life doesn't get any better in my world. I couldn't be happier. It just doesn't get any better.
Well, I'd like to give Bruce Harvey here a special congratulations on this great ram he set out. The Texas Parks and Wildlife issued a tag on this particular ram, and we'd seen a picture of him, and Bruce fell in love with him. He's put in a lot of work, a lot of time into this sheep, and it paid off today. What's the date? July 27th? July 28th, and the permit expires July the 31st. So to say, we cut it short is an understatement. But anyways, I mean, it's a great sheep, old, mature ram. I'd like to thank all my crew here. Wouldn't be able to do it without them. They do me more than I could ever do for them.
They shift gears when it's game on. They're dead serious, and all three of these guys sitting behind me can spot really, really, really well. Steve, he is a production guy, but I've hunted with Steve in Idaho before. We go back several years, and I've got some of the best eyes that I would know of on this hunt. I've got the best help that anybody could ever hope for on this hunt. All these guys, High West, Desert Taxidermist, Emotion Films. Steve isn't just filming when he's not running the camera. He's got binoculars up and carrying his weight and looking for animals and spotting animals. It's just, it's been a group effort. And I think to get this guy right here, it took a group. This was not an easy task, I don't think.
No.
It was not an easy task. It's just the fun things that we do that not a typical hunt.
Oh yeah, look here, Tommy, we got a selfie going on here. Here we
go. Great group of guys, all get along. They're more full of shit than I am, but that's okay. It was just cool. It's the coolest experience that I've ever had. It's, I don't know what else to say, it's just awesome.